It's about the time, and that's going down. And we ain't let nothing stop us, ain't no slowing down. Nah, it's Kingdom Marketing Season. And every single week, you gotta be
I think it's finally time. I think it's time to flow. I think it's time to start this podcast so they can know the right tips and strategies that bring success. It calls heaven on earth and our business. But this is all true because he changed the game. It brought the kingdom to every soul representing his name. Now position yourself in him to be blessed and bring heaven on earth in your business. It's about that time and that's going down. And we ain't letting nothing stop us, ain't no slowing down. Nah, it's Kingdom Marketing Secrets. And every single week you gotta pick this. It's about the time, and now it's going down. And we ain't letting nothing stop us, ain't no slowing down. Nah, it's Kingdom Marketing Secrets. And every single week you gotta pick this.
Welcome to Kingdom Marketing Secrets, where you'll hear the best tips, tactics, and takeaways, and any other cool words starting with T, so you can advance your business online the Kingdom way. Welcome your host, Christopher Harold.
What's up? What's up? What's going on, my friend? What's happening? It's your host with the most. I'm back, my friend, for episode 84. It's the Kingdom Marketing Superman himself, Christopher Harold, founder of God's Masterpiece, one of the fastest growing communities today for Kingdom Entrepreneurs. And I'm excited to be before you for episode 84 of the Kingdom Marketing Secrets Podcast. And my friend, we're about to blow your mind with this episode today, because this episode here and this month, something big is happening right now while I'm sharing this with you. If you happen to be watching this on video, either Facebook or YouTube or wherever you see my sneak previews of my podcast, don't let the camera deceive you. Yes, I am coming fresh off a brand new music video shoot that we just did. You guys know I love music. I love to use music in my business and everything like that, right? Well, if you can see me right now, and for those who are listening, just use your imagination. Imagine stepping into a castle, coming into a throne room, and seeing a handsome, vibrant, hunk of a man, intellectual, kingdom man, there in his royal wardrobe. Yes, right now, I have my king robe and king crown on because, well, I'm a king, right? And if you're a male, if you're in a kingdom, you're a king. And if you're a lady and you're in a kingdom, you're a queen. But I am dressed in full gear right now for this episode because we're fresh off our brand new music video because something big is happening right now. I'm here and happily can announce to you my much anticipated, my goodness, highly sought after. Literally, I had people for months and months and months and months begging me to release this book. And now I can finally tell the whole world right now, especially you guys who are my loyal subscribers, that I have finally released my brand new book that's already crushing it on Amazon. Kingdom Affirmations. Yes, I wrote a brand new book called Kingdom Affirmations, How to Activate the Power of Heaven on Earth in Your Words. And now, for you guys who are my subscribers, for you guys, you can go to kingdomaffirmations.com. I have put together a very special offer just for you there. Go to kingdomaffirmations.com. I mean, literally, I can show you the emails. I've had people inboxing me, asking me, when is this book going to be ready? When is this book going to be ready? When is this book going to be ready? Right? And I thought I'd be done in early 2020, but life happens. COVID happens, things happen, and our timing could not be perfect. And what I've done for this month of March 2021, I have dedicated this to calling this Kingdom Month. This is Kingdom Month, this month of March. And now, I'm dedicating this to the release of my book, Kingdom Affirmations, that will radically transform your life. Oh my goodness. The testimonials from this and the reviews from this has just been crazy, right? But right now, you can go and buy the book. Plus, I made an amazing audiobook to go with it. You know me, I'm very musical. The audiobook is going to blow your mind. And like I said, I did a brand new song for this book. And we just shot the music video this past weekend in downtown Dallas. And literally, we had stopped traffic. We was in the middle of the street. We got all kinds of different sets, all kinds of different scenes. It's going to blow your mind. So I can't wait to release the music video for this as well, my friend. But what I'm telling you right now, the wait is over. You can go right now to kingdomaffirmations.com and get this book, get the audio book. I have some very special bonuses for you as well that you will only get by going to kingdomaffirmations.com. If you go to like the other site, you know, that's been selling on the big A, you will not get these other bonuses. You will not get access to the other treats and valuable resources I have available for you there. So go to kingdomaffirmations.com. And here's something that literally I just thought of before this episode right now. I am going to do another free bonus for everyone who purchases this book. And especially if you get the audiobook. But I'm going to do something special just for you guys. I'm going to do a bonus session, a bonus class just for you guys. So go and purchase it. I was putting everything together where I'm going to do this bonus class where I'm actually going to show you how to truly get the most out of this book, out of the audiobook as well. So this class will be done. Most likely, I have not put a date on it yet, but I'm looking at a Saturday morning so that everyone can attend. All right. And I hope my plan is to do it one Saturday in March. So go and buy the book right now. Go to kingdomaffirmations.com, get the audiobook as well, and just other resources and bonuses I have for you there as well. So, in today's episode, and every episode this month, I'm going to be talking about the kingdom and taking different things from the theme of my book as well. So, in this episode here, I want to start with, do affirmations actually work? You know, my book is called Kingdom Affirmations, you know. And but the question is, do affirmations actually work? And I talk about this in my book, like, why did I write this book? You know, you should always have motives for doing something, right? So I kind of talked about this a little bit in my book, but I'm not going to dive into that so much. I'm talking about a little bit, but I can remember this, and I'm going to share a little bit of my story. Like, I, for 20 plus years, you know, have been a serial entrepreneur. I started my very first business in 1998. And I'm looking at page 3 of my book right here, where I was talking about why did I put this book together. And I was saying that, hey, well, throughout my 20 plus years now as a serial entrepreneur, I've tried everything under the sun. I almost sold anything you can think of. And when I met someone who was really successful in the business I was in at that time, they all told me they did affirmations. Right? Now, so that's like when I'm starting telling you why I wrote this book. There's a lot more stuff in there. I even dive into the scientific benefit of these. But let me share this. For most people, even for myself, affirmations did not produce the results that I wanted. That's one of the reasons why I wrote this book. Right? Because literally, I would record myself saying these affirmations and listen to them, all this kind of stuff. But yet, I was unable to manifest the results of these things. And we're gonna talk about that today in this episode here. Maybe you're like me, maybe you can relate. Maybe you tried some affirmations and it just didn't work. And for you, and usually for 97% of people, they don't work. They don't work. I'm gonna talk about that today. And I'm gonna share some other stuff with you from this book as well, my friend. It's gonna blow your mind. And on page 6 is when I get into why doesn't it work, right? And so we're gonna touch on this a little bit. I dive into some really dope scientific stuff starting on page 6. It's gonna blow your mind. But let's talk about this. What are affirmations, right? Well, affirmations are very specific declarations. I wrote this down, positive or negative, that can alter beliefs about yourself. Now, I talk about this stuff all the time. All my God's Masterpiece clients and students know, you know, that's our program for our Kingdom Entrepreneurs who are going to a high level in their life and business. inside of God's masterpiece, right? And I talk about this stuff all the time because it's true. Mindset is everything. But affirmations are actually declarations. And I talk about why declarations are powerful scientifically in the book. Maybe in another episode, I'll dive into that more. But that's what they are. See, the more you think and act on certain beliefs, the more the neurons, in your brain are fired to create a pattern that's reinforced. See, your thoughts and actions are habits that you have learned, right? See, they're habits. And one thing I've discovered is that if you change your habits, you can change your life. For most people, their habits have a stronghold on them. So it's very difficult for them to begin to change their life. Hopefully this is making sense to some of you guys, right? So, but here's a powerful thing. Our brains and our minds can be altered. Our brains and our minds can be altered. They're not fixed. That's the beautiful thing about this. You can learn new things and change, right? Just because you're a certain way today doesn't mean you're stuck that way for the rest of your life. So our brains can be grow, but truth be told, statistics say that people only use 5% of their mind's potential and mind's power during the entire lifetime. That's a scary statistic, but it's true. Now, the problem with most affirmations, especially with secular affirmations, right, is that they tend to focus on materialism and hedonism, where it's almost a self-worship of yourself, right? And you try to convince yourself you're something that you're not. And they focus on materialistic things. I can remember many times I was doing these affirmations, right? You know, saying, sitting there and doing this subconscious meditations. I was doing this stuff, literally subconscious meditation, all these crazy affirmations, right? Trying to manifest these things. Having a vision board on my wall, seeing all these big houses and these big cars and all this money, all this stuff, right? And the secret is lied to us. You know, the secret fools you. Right. But it wasn't manifesting. Right. Now, the reason why secular affirmations don't work for most people, for many, is because people have low self-esteem. Right. They don't believe they're worthy of anything or they don't believe it's true. Right. It doesn't matter what you might think. If you don't believe it, it won't happen. They don't practice mindfulness. They don't keep themselves aware of what's happening. They're resistant to change. A lot of folks changing is a lot of work, and most folks are resistant to it because they're comfortable being where they are in status quo. They have internal conflict, but more importantly, it's more inside internal conflict. These things conflict with your values, what you believe, what you stand for. It contradicts your faith. It contradicts who you are and your identity. That's why secular affirmations don't work for 97% of people. That's the reason why kingdom affirmations are so important, because you need to know who God says you are, who your creator says you are, right? And I'll give you another cool little bonus, this little bookmark. I got some powerful affirmations on here for you as well. But see, that's why one reason why I wrote this book. Because you can get caught up in idolatry, where you're after things and chasing things by trying to do secular affirmations, but not with kingdom affirmations, because kingdom affirmations come from your creator, right? Comes from who he say you are. Why? Because your creator knows you better than we know ourselves. Is this making sense? I hope this is making sense to you. So the major reason why, you know, these affirmations, these secular affirmations don't work, is because of the internal conflict with yourself. And that's why every person needs to read this book, Kingdom Affirmation, especially if you are a believer or someone who wants to build a profitable kingdom business. See, for many, many, many years, I struggled trying to bring things to fruition, right? I was saying all the secret sayings of the gurus, all the mantras, all those things, yet I had no tangible results to show for it, right? And it left me with frustration. It left me with disappointment and heartache and heartbreak at the same time as well. And let me go to another page here really quick. Let me read you. See, you can have a good idea. And doing secular affirmations are